Hello
and welcome. It's a pleasure. Panicos Corner would say Tollgate again. But this is our last beer from Tollgate.
Well, it did mention though, that the walnut is similar to the
old Rasputin.
But you can never be sure.
Yeah.
So you can always try it and see if you get anything.
Slight bit of charcoal. 4.9%.
Yeah.
It's bottle conditioned. It did say on the internet it was 4.3. Mm-hmm. I'm just trying to see for the if you've poured any sediment in it.
Smell it for water.
Yeah, charcoal. A little bit of cola.
It kind of comes off as a little sweeter on the back. I'll give it an extra pour.
Taste it first. Then we'll do the shake. And it's pretty clean. There's a bit of, again, charcoal and berry taste. Slight woodiness.
It's not as good as the Rasputin.
No.
The Rasputin's really nice. It's sort of a lighter version, I'd say. You'll get support. So, yeah. There you go.
Shut it up.
That's fine.
It's not
kind of light brown, isn't it?
For a stout, it's not dark on the head, is it? It's very, I'd say, off white. Than anything else. Body's dark with a, like a,
I see a little red tinge in there.
Yeah.
Sort of like almost like a dark red beer.
It's a little bit more okay.
It's smooth there.
Main malts was Mupa, roast barley and chocolate. Main hops were Pacific Gem, Willamette. Ingredients, water, barley, wheat, hops and yeast, not else. Supple for vegans, contains gluten. Dark, supple and very smooth with just a bitterness and a traditional stamp provides a great combination for a sensible. Enjoying that in time. Yeah, the internet said 4.3, so they must have altered it.
Mm.
I mean, they altered the old Rasputin as well. It was a lower ABV, and the ABV went up. And I think this has done the same. They've changed it.
Well, that was batch 66, which we're drinking now.
Expires March 40. It's a tasty session stout. It's okay.
Sort of kind of get a brainy taste, like as if you're eating runner beans or something. Or,
do you know what it is? It tastes like
what?
A bit of cola, charcoal, dark berries. But it's, if I was to describe this as a beer, it'd be a beer festival beer or a pub beer. Basically, you buy it. And then you'd forget about it.
Yeah, it's nice enough.
But I think that's the problem when you come across a solid brewery. They're all okay, but they're not outstanding. I mean, it's the same with some other breweries. And they're all good, but they're just all good. Nothing outstanding.
Well, anyway, this is a dried timber of the walnut. It's chocolate brown, black.
I mean, if you wanted a couple of beers just unwind, this would be perfect. But again, it's not.
See, the head's gone really quick, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It's quite nice.
I still buy it.
Yeah.
It's a go-to beer. more than anything else. It's a beer you go to if you want a quick couple of beers.
Mm.
What's that one that you had this week, and the farmer's blonde and all that stuff?
Brown cow. From Bradfield.
Bradfield. Bradfield are very similar, aren't they? Yeah. Basically, you can look at
you can drink their beer.
If you're in the shop, you'd be looking at it thinking, I want a beer. That's a solid brewery. That's a solid brewery. That's the beers we've had are solid.
Bradfield one we started up on from
Sheffield.
The shop.
Salty Wines.
That's it. Yeah, because we used to go to Salty Wines and we got a lot of Bradfield beers from there. And Bradfield beers are good, just like Tollgate, they're good beers.
Yeah, we've never had a bad Tollgate beer. They've just been...
Oh, Bradfield, you know what I mean? Yeah.
They've just been good beers.
Yeah, it's a good beer.
Yeah, a go-to beer. One final taste. Yeah, nice, lovely taste of beer.
There's no disappointment there. It's just nice.
You take care. Goodbye.